This is the sixth letter in Alam Letrufa, a letter written by Rav Nosson Zatzal. Be'ezras Hashem Yisbarach, Yoim Beis Chaye Sora, Tavkif Pei Dalet Breslev. Shalom Abracha V'chayim V'chol Tov L'chvoid B'ni Mareinu Rav Yitzchak Sheyichya. Peace, blessing, and life, and all good to my honored son, Rav Yitzchak, may he live. In Resecha Ne'imim Higiye Leipamayim. I received your pleasant words twice. Aleph, b'yom simchas Torah, b'esha yinus meichem b'simcha shein leketz. The first was on simchas Torah, at the time that we were rejoicing in the happiness that has no end. Simchas Yisrael, the rejoicing of Israel, asher zechinu li asam segilosoi, v'nasan lanu kli chamdosoi, that we merited to be his treasured nation, and he gave us his treasured vessel, his treasured tool, v'kevonu l'avaydosoi, and he brought us close to his service. Then during our rejoicing, I received your letter. I saw and I enjoyed. Befrat beigeres hasheni. I rejoiced over your words, especially in the second letter. Asher kibalti b'shavua over, which I received in the previous week. Asher hodiani es asher kifsa nafshi. That you have notified me that which my heart, which my soul desires. Asher toidela el toiris Hashem tamima biyotcha, that praises the Lord, that Hashem's perfect Torah is in your hands. No b'ni chavivi kenafshi. Now my beloved son, that I love as much as my soul. Chazak ve'ematz b'chol koychisecha lahasmid b'lamidcha heitev. Strengthen yourself and be courageous with all your power. To be diligent in your studies, to be very diligent in your studies. Ki hi chalkecha b'chaim, because this is your lot in life. Toiv legever ki yisa oil b'nirav. It is good for a man to carry the yoke in his youth. V'gam tis amitz b'yoyse l'spal b'chavona g'doyla, shetachnes kol machshav aysecha l'soich kol dibir v'dibir shal tfila. And also you should strengthen yourself very much to pray with great concentration, that you should bring into your intellect, your mind, you should bring your mind into every single word of prayer. Shetachaven perish amilos b'chol atfilos, that you should concentrate on the definition of the words by all your prayer. By all your prayers. V'sechoiz machshavtecha tomid leval teshoitet machshavtecha unu va'ona kedakcha mikvar. And you should take hold of your mind constantly. You should not let it go astray here and there as you have typically done. Ata b'ni kalich miderech hazeh. Now my son deceives from this way. He zorv v'yizorv v'siz gabe v'siz chazek v'chol mine koiches v'eitzos losir miderech hazeh. Be careful and be careful and be very strong and strengthen yourself with all types of powers and all types of strategies to turn away from this way. Rather, take hold of your mind with your hands to not let any external thought get in. Because the thoughts of a person is in his hand to lead it where it is. And it is impossible for a person to have two thoughts at the same time. As the Rebbe speaks of this a lot. Because a person that his mind constantly thinks a lot is one of the things that holds him back from repentance. And more than what I've written now, bni, hizor v'hizor ma'oid ma'oid sa'ayin heite b'sifra rabbeinu zechrenu racha. Be careful and be careful very, very much. And look well, delve well into the svarim of our Rebbe. May he be blessed. V'simtza eitzos v'sachbilos le'inotzo mizeh. And look at and find advice and strategies how to save yourself from this. Ve'ikar hima shekasafti lamala. And the main thing is what I have written above. Shateida v'tama b'meshaom rabbeinu zechrenu racha. That believe and know the words that the Rebbe, may his memory be blessed, said. Shamachshava b'yada adam la'atoysa kitzoynoi l'makam shiroitza. That the mind is in a person's hand to lead it where he wants and where his will is. V'ome shafila m'machshava noite. Chaz v'chalila, that even if a thought were to go astray, God forbid, l'fa'omim min atzad, sometimes from the side, yesh b'yad ha'odom l'tzofso l'ashiva l'mkoyim aroi, it is in a person's hand and power to grab it back to the place where it belongs. Just as a horse that strays from the path, that you one can grab it by the reins and bring it back to the straight path. So too is exactly the same for a thought. As it's brought in the Holy Sfarim, and especially during the times of prayer, then, especially then, everybody gets confounding, confusion of thoughts. All the thoughts that a person has constantly in his mind, especially during prayer, they come to him. Specifically then, as it's brought down further. Therefore, during prayer, one has to be very, very strong against his alien thoughts. The main thing of overcoming them is with sitting idle and not doing anything. That you should not pay attention and not look at them at all. Rather, think of the words of tefillah that are emerging from your mouth. Then automatically they'll disappear. And also be swift and be strengthen yourself a lot to choose an hour every single day to express your words before your Creator, as you know how much the Rebbe, may his memory be blessed, spoke about this. And this is a general advice for every one of us to merit to the holiness of Am Yisrael. And there's nothing more to write on this. I can't write any more about this. There wouldn't be enough paper or parchment to write on. Rather, place your eyes and your heart on the Svarim of our Rebbe, may his memory blessed, with Simtzum Argoyle Nafshecha, and find a relaxant for your soul, that it should be good for you forever and for eternity.